5:45 in the morning, Birmingham, new destination. I've already done the check-in for my bike and we are almost ready to go to the gate and wait for my flight. Can't wait to show you where I'm going. I'm so excited. I'm just arrived in Metron, as you can see on the sign, and we are going to meet Dimitris that will explain us what Metron does for MYTHOS Bike. Let's go. Hi Dimitris.
Hey Francesca, welcome.
Thank you.
So come, we'll show you a little bit around of what we do. We do a lot of things that they have to do with handlebars and 3D printing. So we have like a lot of things that we do in titanium in 3D printing. We also do in a material called scalm alloy, which is the high strength aluminium alloy. And our newest and best is actually our new handlebar, which it is actually working really well in terms of creating a time trial position. That's your special one with your name on.
Yeah, that's right.
Our new brand is the MYTHOS, which actually is only about a year old, but it makes waves, as they say, so hopefully we're going to do better and better on that.
Yeah, I hope so.
We do quite a lot of different things over here. Some of these things, they are actually medical parts. This is like what they call a hip replacement. That's the bit that actually goes in the pelvis, and you have like this very fine mesh where the bone is actually growing in. We do a number of things that they have to do with motorsport and racing cars. So this is actually a part from an old part from a racing car. So this is like a part which it is on a bike that is made out of carbon and titanium 3D printed lugs. You can do a lot of very strange shapes with 3D printing. So this is actually a replacement part with that we did for a project that I cannot tell you much, unfortunately. Sometimes we even do art. Actually, this is only a small part of a bigger sculpture that it was all in titanium. If you ask me what it is, to be fair, I'm not quite sure, but that's what art is. Metron is an aerospace qualified company, so we apply the same care and attention and detail to everything we do because we are qualified to make aerospace parts. So there is a lot of records that we have to keep. There are a lot of procedures that we have to follow to make sure that everything is happening as it's supposed to be. So we have to keep all these systems. Okay, you get to see that. This is the software that controls the whole machine. A very important part of when you're making the parts is to actually keep very detailed records. So as the machine is making the parts, it's taking a picture every single layer. So then you can go back and inspect that, was that a successful build, and you can actually detect problems if there is any porosity or something that didn't work very well. So this is actually when we were making your handlebar,
yeah,
and also the adjustable stem that we will be using in the wind tunnel is actually this part over here and that part over here. And you can see the shape changes gradually.
Yeah.
So this is actually as the component grows, literally just grows up. So the inside of the machine has to be very, very clean, so you have to have gloves to catch it. This is an electron beam melting machine, so in effect you have like a beam of electrons that they hit the titanium powder and it's melting it. And it's working on a high temperature, so this is working at around 700 degrees inside. So this is what they call a heat sink, so it stops the heat coming out. So if I take that out, you can see down there, this is really where the plate sits. Over here there is no plate right now, but that's where the plate sits, and the beam comes from the top and it hits it. And the powder sits actually on these two things on the side. And the machine is putting a little bit of powder over, table goes down and beam is melting it, and then you do it again. Okay. The other machine, which is this one, which unfortunately I cannot show you in because it makes some parts that I may have to kill you if I show you. This machine is a laser machine, so it uses a laser beam that it goes on and melts the material. On this machine we do scalm alloy parts, so this is like a high strength aluminium alloy that is developed by an Airbus subsidiary, so this is actually used on aircraft, Formula One and bicycles.
Yeah, of course.
So So that's the laser machine. The other machine we saw before is the electron beam melting machine. They work more or less the same. Both they put a thin layer of powder, and then you have the beam coming on and melting the material.
This is a TT handlebar.
Yeah, this is a TT handlebar that's going out to a customer today. So we're just doing the final bits to make it fit together.
Looks good.
Looks better when it's all together.
So what are you doing?
Yeah, so this is for the wind tunnel test tomorrow so that we can test the stem length, so we can measure the stem length so we know which stem position we put you in. So if you look from the side here, you've got the front stem will go on there and the back stem will go on here, and then we'll be able to measure the where this point is in relation to this point so that we can do a stem that puts you in the position that we find for you in the wind tunnel.
That's perfect. Good job.